Hey, welcome to Grafana for Beginners. I'm Lisa Jung, and I'm a developer advocate at Grafana. In the previous episode, we talked about how Grafana is used to observe your system as a part of your DevOps practice. We also talked about three ways that Grafana can be deployed. You could self-manage it, or use Grafana Cloud. Self-managing means that you want to install, maintain, and scale your instance of Grafana in your environment. You can do that through two editions of Grafana, open source and the Grafana Enterprise stack. So what's the same and what's different between the two? Well, both editions offer all functionalities of the open source Grafana. With the Enterprise edition, you have the option to upgrade for extra features. So if you have special requirements around data localization and privacy, you may want to start with the Enterprise edition for free and upgrade only when you need it. For what we're covering in the series, it really doesn't matter which edition you choose. You could always switch from one or the other without losing your data. So choose the option that works for you. So for this episode, I'm going to show you how to download and run Grafana on your Mac. The first step is to go to the Grafana download page using the link shown here. The same link is also included in the description. Now you'll see a page like this. The first thing we're going to do is to select the version and the edition of Grafana that we want to download. So let's choose the latest version of Grafana, which at the moment is 10.2.2, and the open source software edition. To keep things simple, this video will focus on how to download and work with Grafana on a Mac. If you're working with a different environment, all you have to do is select the environment on the page. Then you'll see the detailed installation guide that'll walk you through this process. Next, you'll open the terminal app of your choice. I'm going to download Grafana onto my desktop. So let's change the directory to the desktop by typing the command cd desktop as shown here. Now when you hit enter, you'll see that we're in the desktop directory. Then we'll go back to the download page. When you scroll down to the standalone macOS section, you'll see two lines of code here. Now let's copy the first line of code, then paste the code into your terminal and hit enter. This will download the Grafana package. You'll see the Grafana package on your desktop. Uncompress the package by double-clicking on it. Then you'll see a blue folder show up on your desktop. So now we're ready to run Grafana. So let's go back to our terminal. We'll change the directory to the Grafana deployment we just downloaded. So let me just pull up a screenshot of my Grafana deployment here. It's named Grafana-v10.2.2. Depending on which version of Grafana you downloaded, the deployment name will differ, so pay attention to that. Next, I'll use the command cd and the name of the deployment to change the directory. Now you'll see that we're now in the Grafana deployment directory. Now within this directory, we'll run the following command, /bin/grafana/server, then press enter. And you'll see lots of messages popping up in your terminal. Wait a little for these messages to stop scrolling. That means that Grafana is ready to be used. So make sure to keep the terminal open while working with Grafana. Otherwise, Grafana will stop running. If you accidentally close it, just open up a new one and repeat step 6 to get it running again. Okay, so once Grafana is up and running, we'll open a web browser and go to localhost 3000. And it'll take you to the login page here. Now, when you're logging in for the first time, the default username and password are both admin, all lowercase. Enter the info and login. The page will prompt you to change your password, enter and confirm your new password, and hit the submit button. Then it'll take you to the Grafana homepage where you'll get to explore what Grafana can do. Okay, so we just covered how to download and run Grafana on a Mac. In the next episode, I'll show you another way to deploy Grafana, which is via Grafana Cloud. Once we get this out of the way, we'll be exploring what we can do with Grafana dashboards. So this episode is part of the Grafana for Beginners series. To access more episodes, go to the Grafana community webpage. This is where all the community resources are shared. You can access the series by clicking on the Grafana for Beginners card. Now, I also want to introduce the Grafana Sandbox, When you click on the card, it'll take you to the page that displays demos and showcases of Grafana. If you want to see what Grafana is about without installing it or adding a data source to it, go straight to this and play with it to see what it's all about. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.